What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about fixing a CA server issue that I received a while back. So let's get right into it. All right, so I launched my certification authority console and the service basically was stopped. So the first thing that I did was I right-clicked on the server. I went to all tasks. I clicked on start service and I received this particular error. Now, if you really read this error, and the fact that I had my CA server offline for a long time, the first thing that came in my mind was that my CRL expired and something happened, you know, with that particular file. So I closed this up within my intermediate server. I went into the certificate enroll folder and I located my CRL file and I double clicked on it and I went to general. And I saw that the next update was January 21st. Again, the server was offline. So automatically, I wanted to renew this to fix this certificate problem, the CRL file. So the way that I did it is I went inside my root CA server. It is offline. I clicked on start. Within here, I typed in CMD. I right-clicked on the command prompt, and I ran it as an administrator. The first command that I did was the following. I hit enter. Great, it completed successfully. And I opened up the file explorer and I went to this location right here and it created the new file. That's the file. Now this file, we need to grab a USB, you know, make a copy of this because we need to bring it over to your intermediate server. So we're going to head over to our intermediate CA server. We're going to open up the Windows Explorer. We're going to open up the C drive. Within the C drive, we're going to open up Windows. Within Windows, we're going to open up System32. And within System32, we're going to locate and click on the cert SRV folder. Now within here, we're going to go inside the certificate enroll folder, and we're going to drop our new CRL in there. But the old one, I need to rename it. So I'm going to select the old one. I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to click on rename. I'm going to change it to the following and I'm going to hit enter to confirm it. And I got the user account control. I'm going to hit yes here and the name was changed. Awesome. Now we need to drop our new CRL file into this folder. So I dropped it in there. We're good to go. If I double click on the new CRL file, you're going to see that the next update is March 10th, which is awesome. Now I'm going to click on the start button and within here, I'm going to type in CMD. I'm going to right click on the CMD. I'm going to run it as an administrator. I'm going to click yes for the user account control. And we need to run a couple of things. Now I actually got this at the Microsoft site. They provide this information and we need to run the following command. Once you have it typed up, I'm going to hit enter. Awesome. It's done. Completed successfully. That's a good thing. And the next command would be the following. This is actually going to ignore the CRL offline, you know, check. Hit enter here. It went through with no problem. You do need to restart your intermediate server. So I'm going to run the following command of shutdown /R. Hit enter. It's going to prompt me that it's going to sign me out. Eventually, it's going to restart the machine. Log back into your CA server. Click on start, open up your Windows Administrative Tools folder, and click on Certification Authority. Now, if everything works, the service should be automatically running with no problem. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.